congratulations on getting your first professional win within the UFC. I know you got the Dana White Contender Series, but how are you feeling right now for that win?
Elated. Fantastic. A win is a win, you know. I was looking for like a submission. I was looking for more of a knockout finish. So I'm kind of sour about that. Sour about like missing weight. So like that really took a little bit of my joy away. But all the less, you know, I got the finish. So I couldn't be any much happier.
You brought the weight. You were so close to making weight. What was the disconnect there? What happened?
We went to 24-hour fitness. And they had a scale there, and we was thinking like it's gonna be like a pound off, but it happened to be like a pound and a half off. So I'm coming back thinking like, all right, I'm at 37 on this scale. So when I get to a lighter scale, like it'll be a pound difference. So when we got back over by the hotel to do the official weighing and everything, I stepped on the scale that said 138. So I was almost like 2 pounds over. So. I jumped back in the sauna box for 30 minutes, and I came out, and I'm thinking like, okay, I should be somewhere close. I was still like sweating good and everything, and I got to the scale. I was like, oh, you still one over. So I was kind of pissed about that, but you know, like in most situations, every time I ever like travel to a UFC event, like it's always been a good scale at the gym that we were like cutting weight at. So I never had to worry about that up until this point. So it's a lesson learned there. Yeah, that played a part, but at the end of the day, like, you're a professional. Like, you got to be prepared for any curveball to come your way, you know. So, like, I wouldn't blame that. Like, that's just another excuse, man. I fucked up.
On the broadcast, they said that Brian told you he was going to be sending you the 20% that you forfeited back. Did that happen?
Yeah, he told me after the fight, like, he's going to get my money back. So, I don't know, man. Thank that guy.
Hopefully
nice guy.
Changed his mind now that you were working out.
He told me after the fight, you know.
Fight, okay.
Hopefully, you know, he amended his word, so. Can't miss something you never had.
So talk to us about the fight. It seems like once he got him down with that elbow, it seemed like that was really the beginning of the end. Is that what you sensed as well once he got him down? And what were you thinking like once he had him down?
Once I dropped him, I thought, like, you know, like, a cat is most dangerous on his back. So, like, I'm thinking in my head like, all right, I'm trying to continue the attacks, but I gotta attack smart. Like I don't want to rush it and then I get my momentum stopped by getting caught in an arm bar or triangle or something like crazy, you know. So I just took my time, you know, and I ain't commit no fouls, so that's good. And then in the contender series, I had a trifecta, man. I had all three, so like I didn't want to do that again. So I just take my time, you know, and look at what's presented, you know.
A big win. I mean, he's got a win over former champion Henan Barral. I mean, you know, he's been in there with some big names. You know, where do you feel this leads you?
I don't know, man. Probably on the up and up, you know. Like, I'm not going to worry about that, man. I'm just going to get back to training, man. Like, I'm not going to worry about anything I can't control, man. I'm just going to keep doing what I need to win, you know.
When did you know that you had that show again?
I heard him like muffle a little bit, like he's like, pfft. Like, you know, you hear like that last breath, but you can't be fooled by that. You can't be fooled. You gotta like keep applying that consistent pressure. You know, you can't just try to burn your arms out, because what if you didn't like let go of that? Now I gotta fight this guy for the rest of the round with tired arms. So I just kept that consistent pressure, you know, holding that pressure on there, you know. And when I felt that, that's when I turned it on. You know, I'm like, this guy's done. No, usually I don't like traveling with like family or friends, because it like I feel like it's a part of my responsibility to make sure like everything's like all right, they're taken care of, they're not like missing anything, or if anything happens while they're here, like I feel like I'm responsible because I told them to come out here. So I don't want to like add anything to that investment on my part, mentally or physically. So I usually just tell them, if you travel on your own. It's not gonna be like no real contact with me. You know, I'm gonna be focused on the fight and just dialed in. So. And I'm not that nice when I'm cutting weight at all, so I don't know. Like, I'm a nice guy, but like, you know, when you don't got no carbs, you turn into a real piece of shit, you know. So I just, you know, I want them to remember me as a, you know, a positive person, so you know. I just keep him away.
Any concern about the weight coming forward, or is this just a one-off, you know, mishap?
No, man. It was just timing, man. Timing in the scale, man. Not having, you know, a good scale. Like, it's one thing to just miss weight. You miss weight because of this, because of that, you know. Like, I just wasn't prepared. I didn't, like, we got a scale, but we don't travel with it. Because, like I said, the scale's always here, you know. Wherever you're at, it's always a good scale, you know. So, you know where you're at. Like, okay, coming out of, like, setting sun for 15 minutes, you come out, okay, we lost a pound and a half, or we lost a pound. Okay, now we can schedule it out with the time frame given. Like, when you don't have anything that's accurate, it's hard to, you know, to gauge where you're at. So, it was my fault. Next time, we're going to travel with our own scale.
Submission victory as a professional. So now when the athletes are looking at you, they're trying to see where they need to prepare for you. Where should they prepare for you? Are you a striker, or are they going to watch out for your grounding?
The crazy thing about that, man, is I was a high school wrestler, man. So, like, some people think, they look at the record, they think, like, oh, this guy's all striking. Let them think that, man. The getting there is going to be something different, you know? Like, whatever tool I need for a day, I'm going to take that one out. So I pride myself in being that guy that's not one-dimensional, that's not a one-trick pony, that's ready for any and everything. So let them keep thinking that. Let them keep watching that tape and thinking, like, oh, this is the same guy we're going to see. Good luck.
Are there any names that you're looking at in the division?
No, man. I'm here for everybody, man. Like, I'm not just going to say, oh, I specifically want this guy or that. I want them all, you know? To be the best, you got to beat the best. You got to, you know, come one, come all. So whoever, you know, don't make no difference.